It is a way people please show their displeasure to the manner of how certain things are being done. People can boo a president. So many, every leader has been booed at one time or another. I was booed as a member of parliament myself, but it was not an issue. People were sending a message when they behaved in that manner. What violence was there? There was no violence. What risk was there at the life of the president? There was nothing. Now, you all remember, colleagues from the press, that President Akainde was whisked away through the rooftop when he had a press briefing at Sky FM on the Copper Belt. PF cadres came with guns and wanted to shoot him. He was whisked away through the rooftop. That is known to all of you. Tshishimba Kambwini was almost attacked in the cabin when he was addressing, featuring on the radio program. That was a risk to his life. President Akainde at Moha Hotel in Indore was attacked by PF cadres, brandishing guns. That was a risk to his life. But I did not give any risk to Lungu's life in Monze. It was just people flashing their party symbol and shouting their party slogan, which had nothing to do with being disrespectful. The problem in African leadership is we have too much respect, which is not necessary. You all know how Trump, there was a statement in the press which was talking about Trump, that the boss has no boss. It was there, and it was not an issue. There was a statue that was made of Trump in the Trafalgar Square. Nude statue over the president, and that was not an issue. But here, if you want to make an issue out of nothing, first, UPF is the most violent party this country has ever seen. I am privileged to have been around before independence, at independence, and up to now, I'm around. I've seen the colonial government, I've seen the UNIP government, I've seen the non-UNIP government. I can safely say that the PF is the most violent party. You all remember how we scampered in Intercontinental when we went for that BU10 debate. They just brought in cadres from Intercity and we all scampered in all directions. And that to them is not violence. Violence is only when a president is booed. The thinking that the president now is the only president we have had is wrong. And it's not acceptable. We have had a president, he's the fifth or sixth. Meaning we still, even we will have more presidents coming. But what is important is the presidents must know that they are answerable to the people. And if they feel or they fail to satisfy the needs of the people, such reaction can come out. So I want to dispel the rumor and the notion that UPND, the most violent party, as it was said by Dora Siliya, that it's the opposite that is correct. We have Americans now at Intercity. We saw the violence in Mr. Shaker. We have people, commanders. Those are PF cadres. So please, let's respect each other. Lungu's life is as important as HH's life, as important as my life. We are human beings and we all deserve respect. We deserve this life. So I want to appeal that they should not continue portraying other political parties as being violent when they know that they are the ones who are violent. I think I am here. Thank you very much.
In the interest of time, in case there is any pressing question on what Mr. Katuka said,